So we saw generator expressions and functions in Unit 2, but some people in the forum still seemed a bit confused. Don't worry, this is understandable. The generator is an entirely new object and it can be confusing. In the next few videos, we're going to answer three questions. How do we use generators? And I think this is actually an easier question to answer than the second. What is a generator expression slash function slash object? And we'll also talk about when and why do we use generators. So let's start with a problem. We want to compute the sum of the squares of the integers from 1 to 1 million. So that would be 1 plus 4 plus 9. And I probably shouldn't write all of these out. So the question is, how would you do this? And if you came from CS 101, your answer is probably to start with a function. And maybe your function would have looked something like this, where we make an empty list, append all of the squares to that list, and then return the sum of that list. Then you would have called your function with an argument of 1 million, and you would have gotten your answer. First, let me say, this is a fine solution. It gets the job done, but it has some problems. And so keeping in mind that we just want to make this calculation once, what do you think is the biggest problem with this solution? Do you think it's messy and it unnecessarily clutters up the program? Do you think it uses memory when it doesn't really have to? Do you think it runs too slowly, or do you think the code doesn't work? And you may have several problems with this, so it's somewhat subjective. Just choose whatever you think is the biggest problem.